Hello everyone, I'm Rob Watson, the module leader for TECH1502, and this is a short introduction to the topics that we'll be covering in this week's lecture. And the theme this week is community reporting. One of the things that you're going to be doing in the workshops with John is you're going to be working as a community, learning how to be and what's involved in and having a go at being a community reporter. And at the end of the module in May, you're going to be publishing a community newspaper or newsletter or some form of takeaway magazine, journal, newspaper that you can share with people and which will have your writing in and your stories in some form. So what I want to do this week is this isn't quite as intense as the first week, very intense the first week, but this is a bit easier. So I'm actually going to show quite a few clips because I think sometimes we can have a discussion about these rather than it being a formal full-on lecture that will come a little bit later, but what I thought we'd do for the next couple of weeks is look at some case studies of what it means to be a community reporter and how different examples of community reporting have taken place around the UK and maybe even internationally as well, and how people approach community reporting as a different set of practices to formal journalism and formal news management issues. So, what's involved in being a community reporter? How is it different being a community reporter than being a journalist? What are the kind of people that you're likely to be working with? What are the communities? This is a really essential question for us. In what way should we think about the communities that community reporters are part of and serve or represent, rather than merely thinking about people as somebody who kind of is making a living out of or is making a profit out of the interests and the needs of a particular community. So we'll look at some examples from around the country. We've got one from Manchester, we've got one from North Yorkshire, we've got one from Bristol, and they're all very different in the style. Community reporting isn't just about doing things in print. It also includes, podcasts and audio reports. And there's a vast, a real variety of different styles and techniques. But I suppose what it boils down to in the end is kind of the way in which we tell stories to ourselves and to our network of people around us, and also to people who are outside of our community who might wish to understand more about us, or we wish to understand more about them. So it facilitates an exchange of ideas, an exchange of information, and hopefully leads to greater understanding of where our different points of view are coming from. Fairly straightforward lecture today. Quite a few clips in there. I'll post the notes up onto the wiki. They're already there for you to download and see. Bring your notepads with you. Take lots of notes while we're talking and discussing these topics. And in the workshops with John, we'll start the process of investigating what it means to be a community reporter and how this works in practice. And John's got loads of experience of this, practical experience of this, so draw on John's skills and experience in terms of being putting together community newsletters, newspapers, working with BBC Leicester and the Leicester Mercury as well, and why community reporting is different from those kind of mainstream forms of media. So a short video today. Hopefully see you at the lecture on Monday. Are we at the lecture on Monday? Yes, I think we are. If not, see you then. Bye.